made in God's own New Mexico. The sun's up over the mountains, and here's a good one from Lee Greenwood going out for all you jet wranglers and silo jockeys on the morning shift.
If tomorrow all the things were gone, I'd work for all my life, and I had to start again with just my children and my wife. I thank my lucky stars to be living here today, 'cause the flag still stands for freedom and they can't take that away. And I'm proud to be an American, where at least I know I'm free. And I won't forget the men who died, who gave that right to me. And I gladly stand up next to you and defend her still today, 'cause there ain't no doubt I love this land. God bless the USA. From the lakes of Minnesota to the hills of Tennessee, across the plains of Texas, from sea to shining sea, from Detroit down to Houston.
Silo maintenance. Right on time.
Thank you. President of the United States.
It's unfortunate that I could not be here with you on this significant occasion, the annual awards dinner of the National Truck Stop Owners Association. However, I know that you'll enjoy the address to be given by my brother, Lawrence. Sincerely, Franklin G. Hutchins, President of the United States. Ladies and gentlemen, the first brother, so to speak, the Honorable Lawrence Hutchins.
Sorry.
Here.
Wait. All right.
Evening.
Hello, dear. Ladies and gentlemen of the truck stop business, distinguished delegates, friends, graduates, and parents, I'm sure I would find truck stop operations to be a fascinating business. Unfortunately, I've never been to one. Oh, all right. Who gets the award? There you go. I'm out of here. Good night, everybody.
You look lovely.
Keep them rolling.
Vandermender, you're looking harried and out of sorts.
Thank you, Larry. I'm sorry to interrupt your evening like this, but since it was just another rubber chicken affair...
Actually, the food was quite good. Must be true what they say about truck stops.
Drink?
No, I never drink while I'm working.
I'm gonna have one. It's been a beast of a day. How are you tonight?
Obnoxious as usual. Poor Frank's probably gonna lose the truck driver vote next
time. It's better than you losing your cover. You're valuable to Frank as a national bozo.
All right, what's been keeping Big Brother up nights? Put on the jerk.
NSA top secret Q clearance file OL8899.
I hate this guy.
At 0600 hours Zulu last Thursday the 23rd, a Thor's hammer missile was stolen from Chaco Base 8, Shiprock, New Mexico. The well-executed mission began with the defeat of the NSA handprint ID matrix. The two...
Zulu,
needed this.
All right, calm down, Vandy. Look, you do the play-by-play.
Okay. Guy got in the silo. The officers in charge thought he was from maintenance.
How did he fool the handprint ID?
Somehow. The critical thing here is the nuke. We've got 72 hours before your brother has to go before the Joint Chiefs on this.
What have we got to go on?
One of the guys got a good look at the fellow before he went down. Pop-Tart. I didn't have any supper.
This is Sam Rawlings.
We haven't heard much from him since the elections in El Salvador.
Will you take it easy, Flash? I'm cooking back here.
President doesn't want the company involved because of Sam's former association. He still may have friends inside. Now, you'll have your usual budget. You'll have discretionary powers. Who do you want for the job?
Foxfire.
I beg your pardon?
Codename Foxfire. She's perfect for this one.
She?
Report to R&D. Elizabeth Pound, 48142, report to R&D. The movie tonight will be Xanadu, starring Olivia Newton-John and Gene Kelly. C block and D block only.
So long, Sid. Look me up when you get out, huh?
I suppose you'll be wanting these.
chica.
Dangerous, but the right man can handle her.
Well, I've put a lot of blood and sweat into this machine.
Unfortunately, blood is no substitute for money, is it? And you're bleeding, aren't you, David?
Well, I'm still waiting to hear from the bank. We have the sales projections and the marketing plans.
And all the time in the world. You need someone to save your company right now, and here I am. I will do it. I will back the prototype in full.
Αν δείστε και δείστε κάπως αγούια.
Разумею.
Well?
What string?
No strings. The usual deal. Fair interest. And then you pay me back when the car starts to sell. One minor detail. I will need full run of the export division for a couple of weeks.
We're not in production yet. Why?
I need to export something rather quickly.
What is it?
A dying man never questions his surgeon.
Got any luggage?
No, just carry on.
Oh, well, we'll take it. In fact, we'll take the car.
Liz.
Hey, haven't you heard of valet parking?
I know you, man. Liz! Hi! I brought you a bottle of champagne.
We don't drink champagne in this neighborhood.
You're so beautiful.
I see you on TV. Liz, can we talk?
We just did.
Liz.
Before you do the weather, man.
Liz, this is really important.
That's right. So is this.
Get you can drop that knife, pal. Drop it. Drop it.
Do you mind? We're talking here. Here, let me help you with this.
So where's your faithful pack of Secret Service hounds?
Oh, they're off someplace cleaning their guns.
You're 4 years too late, Larry.
Actually, I think I'm right on time.
Hey, hold on a minute.
I could have used you in the joint.
Champagne's still cold.
Well, to what do I owe the honor of this breaking and entering?
Liz, the president wants you to know we've been thinking about you. Mother asked us last week. We were at the compound.
Why don't you just cut the crap and tell me why you're here?
We want you to come back to work for us.
I was forcibly retired from the CIA. I served 4 years for something I didn't do. My family won't even return my phone calls, and my old friends cross the street when they see me coming. And after all this, we should just kiss and make up?
Look, my brother and I knew the facts. We were going to break it to the Times, tell them how you were set up. But a dozen men and their families would have been killed in Santiago the next day. We could not blow the cover for all those people.
You and I both know that in this business, people are secondary. Politics comes first.
You knew the drill when you took the job? What did you think we meant? If caught, the government will disavow all knowledge? Hey, just kidding.
What I want from my government is an apology.
We're sorry.
And I want it in writing so I can vote. You know, your brother may need me next time around.
He needs you now. Look, Liz, you had a great career going, then you had the rug pulled out from under you. We just want to give you something to stand on again.
Hey, this is me talking. This is not my brother, not the Secret Service, not the CIA. It's just me. You owe me at least a hearing.
Okay, I'll hear you out.
All right, here's something Tom Brokaw didn't tell you on the evening news. Somebody ripped off one of our nicer missiles.
You got any leads? This is what you're doing here.
And this is why I got an early parole.
Sam Rawlings.
The nightmare who walks like a man. Come on, you know him better than anybody in the world.
Yeah, I know him. I know him real well. I had some plans once. Marriage, kids, house in Connecticut. Then he left me in that hotel in Bogota with a bullet in my shoulder and 5 million counterfeit pesos.
You mustn't be sentimental about it. Sam's black widow, Martine Vitelli.
Oh, yeah, I've heard of her. She was the poster girl for the Bader-Meinhof gang.
Mm-hmm. Kind of woman you want to bring home to Mama. If you want to kill Mama. She's been seen spending money on the Upper East Side.
That's a good place to do that.
What do you say? You want Sam? Uncle Sam wants him. Trail her, you find him.
1,560 days. I only had one thing on my mind. That's to get Sam Rawlings.
And you thought your government had forgotten about you.
Every day, but in this tale I tell, the sun no shine, it's dark as hell. There was a man called Sam, had a lovely girl named Liz. They lived so happily, but Sam was bad, and he went away. Foxfire, la 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 la, Foxfire. Like love, it cannot last. Tweet it, tweet, tweedly, tweet, tweet, tweet it, tweet, tweedly, tweet, tweet, tweet it, tweet, tweedly, tweet, tweet, tweet it, tweet.
Co to jest?
It's Foxfire. She wants to see me.
So Sam got your singing telegram. What makes you think he'll bite? Sorry. Well, this place will be tough to secure. Put a couple of guys in the bedroom and a guy out in the hall and, of course, the front and the back of the building.
Just not gonna work. I gotta meet him alone. Sam's too good, you know. Would lose him. Besides, I can't meet him in a place like this.
What do you mean?
Well, I'm gonna need a better place. Sam's an uptown kind of guy.
What do you mean?
You already asked me that. I got a great idea. Why not your place? You know, I saw your penthouse once in Better Homes and Gardens.
My place?
Yeah, and I'm gonna need a few things. You know, the right clothes for the job. Sharks like shiny things.
Sure. Go out and buy yourself a new pair of shoes.
Thank you.
Sable? You want Sable? What was wrong with the minks?
Larry, Sable is what minks would wear if they had money.
Is the coat getting in the car, too?
Oh, I don't know. Rubies are so,
expensive.
Red. Let me see a nice classic blue-white diamond.
The king will be very angry to know that you demand a body search of his favorite wife.
I'm terribly sorry, Your Highness. We have no choice. This is store policy. First, the earrings were on the table, then they were gone.
Oh, well, I cannot be responsible for your clerk's carelessness.
I completely understand your point of view. Could I just suggest...
How dare you touch the royal person? It is against our religion for to be touching.
The last time I saw Her Highness, she was Maggie Bryan from Detroit doing 3 to 6 for grand larceny.
Do you want me to call my embassy? Do you want me to call the UN? Do you want war with Gabon?
Excuse me, perhaps I can be of some service. I speak the language, you know. You know, you'll never make it out of here. I'm just trying to help.
There is an old saying in my country. Mind your own business.
You know, I hate to see you in so much distress, Your Highness. Perhaps the earrings fell accidentally into the folds of your dress. Oh! My goodness. Here you are.
Well, there's one. Now may we have the other?
I owe you one.
Security?
There's no way out. Stop! Stop! Come back.
Foxy! Hasn't lost their touch.
I'm all for looking nice, but don't you think we ought to get after Sam and our missile?
Well, you know, there's a method to my madness and your money. I mean, it's gonna take Sam a while to move his missile, and it's gonna take me a while to move Sam.
The living room, good for parties and playing catch. New York's out here. Want to see it?
Nice view.
It came with the apartment. The kitchen. Got a new blender from the Defense Department. It doesn't work. Nice little tub for two. You know, you really ought to see this with the sunset.
Where will you be, thank?
Not here?
No.
Mother has a little place in the 80s. Lots of cats. I don't really like cats.
Well, you know, Larry, everything is perfect, but there's just one thing. I can't sleep on this polar bear.
What did I tell you? That spread is the only item in the apartment personally selected by Mr. Hutchins.
This is Phillips. He's been with our family for 200 years now.
I don't do housework. I don't shop. I don't drive on weekends, and I get Thursday off. Are there any questions, madam?
Yes. What do you do on Thursdays?
I'm sure we get on just fine. I understand this will be a dinner party this evening. How many?
Two.
I still don't like it. You know, I could put a man in the elevator. In the right uniform, Sam would never suspect a trap.
Nothing doing.
I was thinking escargot to start.
Fine. Not too much garlic.
All right, how about sharpshooters with high-powered rifles on the ledge across the way?
Absolutely not. Now, what I will need is a small bug, the smallest one you can find, so I can plant it on him.
Endive salad.
How are you going to plant a bug on him?
Sam was always partial to white roses.
Dover sole.
Liz, for God's sake, this man's a dangerous killer.
Oh. Steak tartare.
I beg your pardon.
May I make so bold as to say how hot Madam looks this evening?
Yes, you may be so bold. Thank you, Phillips.
I just want you to know that whatever happens, I'll be only a scream away.
Young, my friend.
But fleeting.
Oh, you remember that fella Gomez, the one who used to be such a whiz with the explosives?
Oh, yes, I remember. Now, he got a little careless. He went up in that post office blast last October in Beirut. May he rest in pieces. Phillips, the steak tartare was delicious.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. I thought it might suit you. Will there be anything else, madam?
Konya?
Well, you must have learned quite a trade in prison to be able to afford a place like this.
Oh, I certainly did. I studied small engine repair.
Well, you couldn't be working for the company. My friends there say you're still persona mucho non grata.
Well, no wonder after what they think I did, but actually what you did to me in South America.
I tried to get to you. The streets were swarming with polizia. I would have been shot on sight.
I can understand exactly how they might have felt.
Liz, come on. Shouldn't we just let the dead bury the dead?
Yeah, maybe we should.
I've missed you.
You sort of get your blood stirring.
Why, thank you, Phillips.
This cognac is older than God. Will there be anything else?
Yes, why don't you go to Chicago and then wait for further instructions? Liz, you're a very complex woman. But I don't think you're a saint. Why do you want to see me after all the grief I've caused you?
Strictly business, Sam. Nothing personal.
What a shame.
The shame is in the mistake you're about to make.
I'm a big boy.
I remember. What happened, Sam?
Come on. It happened to you, too. It happens to everybody if they're paying attention. There's no just cause, just business. I went where I could find the best deal. There's room for you, too. And when it's over, we'll have more than enough to quit the game for good.
I guess that means you still have the merchandise. Perhaps another bid will help change your mind.
The deal is down. I don't go back on deals.
I have with me a blank check, and I just think that if you don't take it, you'll be the one to bounce.
Well, I guess we're right back where we started, aren't we? I can't buy you, and you can't buy me.
How can we stand all this integrity?
No, no, no.
How bloody inconvenient. You have a beeper, and I have a butler.
It's been nice seeing you, Liz. But if I were you, I wouldn't try it again.
But you're not me.
Dinner was delicious, Phillips.
I live to cook, sir.
I won't be in touch.
Is there another way out of here? A faster way?
There's an express elevator Mr. Hutchins uses in emergencies through the kitchen.
Good, let's go.
Me?
You're driving.
Perfect.
No, we'll just sit tight. Let's go, Phillips. Step on it.
I am stepping on it. Just because we're chasing someone doesn't mean we can't be careful.
Nothing personal, but I'm going to need a driver.
Morning.
Oh, good morning, madam. Coffee?
Please. You look none the worse for wear.
One gets used to it.
Oh, this looks fabulous, Phillips, but I couldn't eat it.
Oh, very well.
For you to pour down the sink.
I haven't eaten eggs since the Republican convention of 1972.
Political statement?
No, that's when my doctor told me I had too much cholesterol. Then he warned me about sugar. Next came caffeine, then salt, then red meat. And then he died.
Hey, you still look like a virile, red-blooded kind of guy to me.
I will be after I take my blood pressure medicine.
We gotta move. Where's Larry?
He called. He's running a little late. I have to feed his mother's cat.
What an operation. Hey, Phillips, what's it like to work for that family?
Polo, politics, touch football in the library. But don't let all that power and money fool you. Underneath it all, they're really quite greedy. I suppose the boys did all right. One's the president and one's not.
Well, why do you work for the one that's not?
Oh, they offered me the White House. But you see, I've always preferred the circus.
And Larry's the clown.
No, madam. The high wire act. One of these days when they write those two books, I wouldn't be surprised if Larry wouldn't turn out more important than his brother.
Well, I guess no president ever had a secret weapon like him.
Phillips! Good morning. Liz? Phillips? Well, I'm starved. Let's have breakfast.
Thank you, sir. We've eaten.
We tailed Sam to Gabriel Motors over in Jersey, and then we lost him.
What does he want with a car company?
I don't know. He was saying something about the shipment, but then he kept turning his back.
You read lips?
Yeah. You know, I have to get into that plant.
Yeah, well, I know David Gabriel, the guy that owns the place. Actually, he's a friend of a friend. His ex-wife knows one of my ex-wife. You can be my mistress.
What?
Your cover. I'll ask David if he can find a job for a lady friend of mine.
Your mistress?
Why not? I do it all. It's done all the time. You certainly have the clothes for it. Oh, Phillips, you'll be dropping me midtown. I got another museum exhibit to open. New Italian artist. Paints with his feet. Oh, and try not to spend all my money on this driver.
Don't worry, I'll drive a hard bargain.
Is he good?
The best.
whatever your trip is, lady, this cab ain't taking it.
Why, I thought you were somebody else.
I am somebody else.
Oh, but I was looking for Crazy Jack. This is his cab, isn't it?
Yeah.
Well, do you want to tell me where I can find him?
St. Elmo's Park over in Queens. He's in the Shepherd's Guarding Their Flock section.
You mean Crazy Jack is dead?
You knew him?
Yeah, I did. I'm really sorry. Real sorry about
that. Well, hey, wait a minute. You're looking for a driver, aren't you?
I was looking for Crazy Jack. He used to do some work for me.
Well, I'm the next best thing. I'm his daughter.
I didn't know Jack had a daughter.
He didn't either until I found the old rascal a couple of years ago. Oh, boy, the best couple of years I ever had. He's a hell of a guy.
Yeah, he was. Quite a guy.
Hey, wait a minute. Wait. I'm your driver. Cloak and dagger, it's my life.
Well, I tell you, I was looking for a...
Oh, man, I know.
Not necessarily. I just need somebody with more experience.
Look, it's 9:05. What if I can get you to the UN Plaza by 9:09?
Some other time, okay? Let's go, Philip.
Very happy here with us.
Well, you know, I'm so grateful for this opportunity, Mr. Gabriel.
Well, it's difficult to refuse a favor for a friend, especially when he's the president's brother.
That does come in handy sometimes, doesn't it? I just want to work ever so hard, Mr. Gabriel. Oh, are you married?
Well, unfortunately, Larry never did send me your resume.
My what?
You know, I mean, what have you done?
Oh, well, last year, Larry and I went to Europe together, and I must tell you that while we were lying in the middle of this
what sort of a job do you feel that you're most qualified to do?
Oh, look at all these fabulous cars. Well, you know, I'm a people lover, Mr. Gabriel. I love people, and people love to love me. So I think I should have a job that allows people to love me. But then again, you know, on the other hand, I do love fresh air, but there aren't a lot of people in the air. Now, you know, Larry thinks that it's very important that I spend a lot of time around people. So I want you to know that what I like to do is... Now, you know what? What I'm trying to tell you is that I like to learn my business from the bottom up. So I'll probably be, you know, spending a lot of time in every nook and cranny around your department store here.
I asked you to get something less conspicuous than a white Rolls Royce.
This car's invisible. Trust me. Cloak and dagger, it's my life.
You're as crazy as your old man.
I love it. One little visit from you, and old Sam folds his hand. You know, the company boys got a tip that he was dumping the goods. Well, we found the warhead on a barge off Pier 61. We got divers down looking for the missile now. I called Frank on the red phone. Yeah, he doesn't like that. He gets very edgy. But when I told him the news, he was ready to throw a parade. He's even looking into that pardon for you. Do you want some champagne?
No, thank you. I'm not thirsty.
Yeah, well, I am. Case closed. Home free.
All you have is a warhead. That just means that he doesn't need it.
What are you talking about?
You hired me because I know Sam better than anybody else, right? Well, then why don't you believe me when I tell you that he's not finished yet?
Yeah, because I don't want to believe you. Look, I want to believe that he panicked and he ran like a normal person. You're right. He's setting us up again.
I have to get into that mansion.
No. Look, it's time for the Marines. You've done your part. Why are you pushing this? Don't worry, we'll get Sam.
You just don't understand, do you? This isn't about Sam anymore. It's about me. I'm back doing the thing in my life that I know how to do best. Now, I lost it once. And I know how it feels to lose it. I want to know how it feels to get it back again.
Okay, Cinderella. One more waltz around the floor.
I'm going to need a team.
Nice roll. Why don't we raise the stakes on the next game?
Oh, Ed. You're one of the richest men in the whole world. Now, what could I possibly have that you might want?
Since you seem to be winning tonight, What would you like?
Well, now, didn't I see you astride a rather magnificent-looking stallion last week in People magazine?
Rashid? You want me to gamble my prize Arabian?
I knew it would be too much to ask.
Thank you very much. Betting is over.
Nonsense. Rashid it is. Nice roll.
Ah, Mr. Hutchins, how nice to see you again. Please don't break anything. I've saved a very nice table for you upstairs. Or would you rather save time and lie on the floor now?
They know me here.
Does he eat much?
I beg your pardon?
Rashid.
I think I better break this up before she causes another major oil crisis.
Oh, a nurse?
And it's hi-ho, Rasheed.
Why, Maggie, Brian, it's so great to see you. We missed you in Gestad this winter, you know. As a matter of fact, I've got to tell you about all these fabulous parties. Mick wore one of my dresses one night. It was just hilarious.
Excuse me.
So much to catch up on. I've got to tell you,
waiter,
I just recently
waiter.
Did this exercise book. And it has changed my life. You know, you lie down on the floor and you imagine yourself running. It's so fabulous.
What is your problem? You know, I'm only going to take so much of this from you, then I'm going to come out of a very nasty bag and land on you.
Maggie, that guy's no challenge for someone like you.
I am losing money here.
I'm just trying to save you from yourself.
I heard that the same place you heard it, in the jug. Now, I didn't buy it from them, and I ain't buying it from you.
I'm not selling anything. I want you to come in with me.
I work for myself, by myself. Partners draw too much smoke. So why don't you just stay on your side of the street?
Come on, Maggie. After all we've been through together, let me take you away from all this. There are an awful lot of people who would really like to take you away from all this.
What are you talking about?
Oh, waiter, may I have a...
Good evening, sir. Would you care for an hors d'oeuvre?
No, thanks. I never eat on an empty stomach. I will have something wet, though. I'll have my usual.
What's that?
Whatever.
You know, you're gonna have to start betting on yourself.
Look, I don't know. The money sounds good. You're not too bad. It's me I don't trust.
I'd leave that up to me.
I've run too long in the gutter. I don't know if I can walk on the sidewalk.
I have no choice, Maggie.
I guess I volunteer. But, baby, are you asking for trouble?
We got her. Let's roll. Larry.
What?
Let's roll.
Already? No, I just saw Mindy Meyerson go into the club room. I haven't seen her since the inauguration. I need to apologize to her for what happened to her little poodle.
A pleasure.
As always.
Wow, nice joint, huh? Must really be the president's brother. Must pay pretty good, too.
I cleaned your rope, madam.
Oh. Thanks, son.
Will there be anything for you, miss? A beer, perhaps, in a paper cup?
Oh, no thanks, Jeeves. I'm driving.
Is that what you call it?
To Frank, congratulations on your election. As always, Art Linkletter. Well, that was really nice of him, you know. He had all that money. He's a nice guy. Hey, listen. I just want you to know, when the hair starts flying, I'm going to be right there to back you up. I mean, really, I've been around the block a few times.
Will you shut up? What are you, a radio show? I got work to do. Besides, I work alone, and right now, I'm working alone for Liz.
Well, excuse me. Forgot I was dealing with Miss Sing Sing, 1984. If you're so good, how come you got caught?
Because I was an empty-headed kid like you, that's why.
Yeah, I'll show you an empty head. How about you and me outside right now? I got a tire iron with your name on it.
I got your tire iron for
well,
you.
Well, let's go outside and see what we can do.
You know, I have just about as much...
Well, I just love to see people happy in their work.
Why didn't you tell me I'd have to be working with a moron elf?
You know, I had just about all I can take from the Queen of Sheba here.
All right, that's enough. You two are going to need each other before the night's out. And I'm going to need both of you. So make up your minds. Leave, or you can stay. If you stay, you follow orders, no questions.
Do I have to keep taking crud from her?
That's a question.
Okay. I take back the tie, Ryan.
I never was much of a team player. Never had the chance.
Got one now.
Let's roll.
I want my company out of it.
Now, we will be out of your hair by morning. The missile goes out tonight, and we follow it to St. Thomas at dawn.
A missile? I figured a creep like you wanted drugs, and I was willing to look the other way. But I want nothing to do with this.
There's no way out. You're in it. That's it. We're a little too far down the road for that.
You even used one of my computer technicians for that printout. We could be up on charges for that.
Enough is enough.
David, I think you're taking all this too personally. Why don't you lie down for a while? We have some medication that might help.
Always.
Okay, I'm gonna need a distraction. I'll be
gotcha.
You. Come on, Maggie.
Thank you.
Out here. God, here's something.
Good evening. You always look great in blue.
You look great in the shower.
I guess you were just in the neighborhood and you decided to drop in on an old friend.
Something like that.
It's a pity you didn't let us know you were coming.
Oh, well, I don't want to trouble you.
Lucky you caught me. I was just about to leave town.
I had heard that.
Oh, what else have you heard?
Enough.
It really doesn't matter whose computer prints the checks, Moscow or Washington.
Moscow's too cheap.
Oh, but if they want something real badly, they break that big red piggy bank.
I see.
Could use you.
Why do I get this peculiar feeling that somewhere down the line, I'm going to be left out in the cold?
The last boat for the islands leaves at dawn.
No, thank you.
Working for the government would keep me out of places like this.
Man, I hope they don't find out about my parking tickets. I'll get 5 years.
Oh, honey, don't even worry about it. We got a get-out-of-jail-free card. Besides, they got cable TV here.
Hi, you okay?
I don't know.
What's the matter?
Larry, you're gonna have to call in the Marines. Sam's done it to me again.
No. You were right. I was the one who wanted to give up. If it weren't for you, we wouldn't be where we are now. Well, maybe I should have put that another way. Anyway, it wasn't easy, but I got you and your bandit crew out on bail.
That's great. Let's go.
Wait, I want to show you the paper. Murdoch has the best headline writers in the business.
What have they got on us?
Well, I'll skip the small stuff like burglary and breaking and entering. They know you're an ex-con. They find you drugged up on the bed with a gun in your hand. Gabriel has a bullet in his head. Oh, yeah, the ballistics match. Oh, and there's a dime bag of heroin on the bedside table.
So why'd you tell the police?
I told them you were having a little trouble adjusting to life on the outside.
This is your captain speaking. We'll be arriving at St. Thomas right on schedule at 10:45. So relax and enjoy our movie, Moment to Moment, starring Lily Tomlin.
Aw, don't worry about a thing, GB. Just have yourself another cheat sheet. It'll take your mind right off it.
Yep. It's going to be a great software convention. I'm doing a floppy disk demonstration myself. You ever seen one of those?
I'm afraid not. Excuse me.
Yeah, well, I'll tell you something. You know, it can be very exciting. Computers are on the cutting edge, you know. Of course, it's not all seminars. I mean, we do get evenings off. How about you?
Actually, you see, I'm not at liberty. I'm being deported.
Deported? Why?
I murdered a computer salesman.
Ladies and gentlemen, coming up on the right side is an excellent view of Nassau.
We're gonna need 3 snack packs from JFK at Fort Bragg.
What?
The JFK Center supplies clean, covert operations equipment. Now, I'm gonna need guns, explosives, and the works. I'll have the green salad, please. Tell them nothing fancy. No Ingrams, no Uzis, no pepper. Just some good old Stens with no numbers. Also, I'm gonna need about 500 yards of Primacort, some gammon grenades, and the grapes.
Oh, our group in Washington figured out what this is. It's a computer graphic printout on the location of every satellite now in orbit, both friendly and hostile.
Well, that rules out land targets for his missile. I think Sam's going duck hunting in space.
I don't know. NSA still thinks the target could be Miami, Havana, El Salvador.
Just add it up. They steal a missile and leave the warhead. He doesn't want to blow something up. He wants to knock something down. And I'm telling you, the target is one of the dots on that piece of paper.
The question is, which one?
Settled. Maggie and I are going to see a man about a plane.
Back like a bad habit. That was the best frame I ever built.
Sind die Koordinaten richtig?
Schöne, gut.
Wunderbar. I'm a little worried about Klaus. He's been hitting the bottle pretty much at night.
Oh, he'll be fine. You think I dragged this guy out of retirement in Paraguay so he could sit around and drink? He'll hit the target. Hell, he blew up half of London. Didn't you, Klaus, huh? Eddie says they took the presidential suite at the Majestic Hotel. Go over there and put out the welcome mat, huh?
He blew his shot in New York. I want her.
Don't take any chances. We're too close to launch time.
Like I said, not only does this guy own me, he loves me.
No, no. Not you. Spodey Odie never wants to see you
again. Spodey man, are you still holding a grudge against that Mexican job?
Those parrots ruined a perfectly good aircraft.
Look, man, I am out of smuggling now. We are into straight stuff and government checks. No bounces.
What do you want?
Well, let's see. I'm gonna need something with a lot of range, twin engine, and an autopilot that works.
Government work, huh?
You know, Maggie here said you were a stand-up kind of guy. So why don't you just stand up?
It's gonna cost you extra for a pilot.
You're looking at the pilot.
Larry,
too good. I'm getting some interference. Sounds like Bill Haley in the comments.
Stay on this channel. If I spot anything that looks like Sam's base, I'll give you a blast.
Liz, careful. Please.
Great.
Lovely. Any luck?
Oh, Zip, I flew over every island, sandbar, and sea turtle for 100 miles around here. Sam's really well hidden. I couldn't see him from the air, and nobody on the ground is talking.
How much time do you think we've got?
Not enough. Your talents never cease to amaze me.
I live to limbo.
Maggie, well, you beat the bushes. What flew out?
A great big goose egg. Nada.
I thought you said you had a reliable network of contacts down here.
Yeah, well, what's that supposed to mean?
I get this impression that your heart isn't exactly in this project.
It ain't. My butt is, and you put it there.
Yeah, let's be ladies.
Stay out of this, beanball. I didn't vote for your brother, and nobody voted for you.
You're over the line, Maggie.
Yeah, well, I'm more than that, because, see, I'm out of here.
Well, maybe the authorities down here would be interested in your background. Jewel theft in New York?
And burglary in Long Island?
Like I said, I'm leaving. And if I were you, see, I wouldn't bother looking for me, because you got lover boy Sam out there somewhere in the jungle with a great big bird in the oven.
What was that all about?
Patience never was her long suit.
Well, what are we gonna do now?
Nothing changes, just one less troublemaker on the payroll.
Beer. Hey, and up to a mama like you, I've been drinking champagne.
Champagne?
They ain't got any. But I got some at my place.
Why don't you crawl back in the swamp?
I had to sit for a sweet young thing like you to get hurt in a nasty old bar like
this. Listen up, Iguana Black. I'm not looking for dark slime like you. I'm looking for offshore Eddie. Now, if you don't know him, why don't you just become a bad memory?
What do you want with Eddie?
That's between me and him.
I'm between you and him.
Okay. There'll be a piece for you.
Waiting's always the hard part.
Not really. Shooting's the worst part.
Yeah. Hell of a way to make a living.
Brother talk you into taking this crazy job?
No, I volunteered.
You did what?
Yeah. Well, see, right after the election, I went to Frank and asked him what I could do to help. I'd been out of the country during the campaign, and I wanted to make up for that. So Frank said, well, what do you want to do? And I said, how about attorney general? And he had a couple of guys come in and drag me out of the office. See, I'm not a lawyer. I have a rule about that over a justice.
It's okay. She had a car waiting.
We really don't need you. We got enough black widows.
You never have enough black widows.
You said you wanted to talk a deal. Talk.
I don't talk to the help. Where's the cheese?
The cheese? This cheese be too sharp for you. Why don't you tell good old Eddie what it is, huh?
I got a woman to sell, Liz Town, and she don't come cheap.
Go fry some fish.
Phillips, I thought you didn't like fish. Never seen you eat so much.
That was in a previous incarnation. Last night, I discovered that life is short.
Well, at least Sam's main chick is flat as a flounder. There's Maggie.
I thought you were yesterday's news.
Get Teddy out of here!
Mission Control.
Not exactly Thunder Mountain, but then I don't have the budget I used to.
Well, what is it you're going for, if you don't mind my asking?
An even 200 million, plus expenses.
Well, now, what is it you're going to shoot down? Let's see, Cuba, Miami, El Salvador.
Nothing so primitive. We're going to bring down a satellite. You see that little fella right there? That's the new American satellite, the Penetrator. There's nothing like that in space. See that one right there? Russian. Totally obsolete. Piece of high-tech garbage. We're gonna bring down the garbage.
The Russians want you to shoot down their satellite.
You see the beauty of this? An American missile fired from American territory. The Russians have justification to retaliate. Bye-bye, Penetrator. And that clock shows just how much time is left before the target is directly overhead.
So you're going to start World War III in space.
You flatter me.
She's the first person who believed in me since my dad died. Who's going to believe in me now?
She saved my life.
Aunt Maggie! Always knew there was something fishy about her. I never trusted her.
I'll never be anybody like madam.
What's all this? Phillips, you're not going to break into song.
Oh, madam!
God. You're alive.
Madam!
You're alive.
Oh, thank God.
Oh, God, are you all right?
Those paramedics are pretty convincing, weren't they?
Why didn't you tell us?
I just couldn't rely on your acting. Although I had to tell Larry, otherwise he might have fainted.
Welcome back, madam. Drinks for everyone or just for me?
I don't understand. What's going on here?
But operating on a need-to-know basis, and what you need to know more than anything else is that you have to trust me.
I think I've earned your trust.
You sure have. And I'm real sorry. Okay. Maggie dropped this in the restaurant. I guess she's got all the information we need to have, so we're gonna have to get her out, and we're gonna have to get her out fast. Come on over, Phillips. Have a look at this. Just what we wanted.
I'm really looking forward to the fireworks.
So am I. Unfortunately, you won't be around. As you may have noticed, I have a passion for neatness. That means no loose threads or women. Eddie, take her to the cabin.
Hey, now wait a minute. I thought I earned a starting position on this team.
I'm taking you out of the game. What? You know, it's a pity. You killed the only person who could have saved you.
I want my money in front.
I don't have any money, and I'm running out of time.
Well, that's too bad, because this goose don't fly until I get some green.
Look, call the Majestic Hotel, ask for Larry Hutchins, tell him I took the plane in to pay for it, okay?
Larry Hutchins, the president's brother?
That's the one.
Wow.
Larry, do you read? Larry, come in.
Yeah, I've got you. Go ahead.
Our only chance is to destroy the missile on the pad. I've said autopilot. I'm going to take her down on the island as close as I can get.
You'll be killed.
I'm not planning on being in the plane when it hits.
Liz, I don't...
Over and out.
Liz.
Gave up a long time ago trying to figure out how you do things.
Just go with it. I promise you I will make up for the last 4 years. This is our time.
I guess all this turns back into a pumpkin now, huh?
I hope not. I have to live here.
I never expected to say this again, but it's been fun.
Oh, we know. You live for fun.
What about Danny and Maggie? Are they gonna be all right?
Oh, yeah, they'll be fine. Danny's back at her hack in the park. She loves her new car, and I guess we'll see Maggie's face in the post office again soon.
Oh, I don't want to forget this. It's your pardon. It's the same stationery Ford used for Nixon.
You really did it.
Yeah, only don't tell anybody. It's official, but we want to keep it a secret. We may want to use you again.
You've got my number.